The case of former Pennsylvania Dr. Kermit Gosnell, who was convicted of murdering three infants born alive during abortion procedures, raises new questions about the practices of abortion providers. One of the latest involves a doctor with a long track record, Dr. Stephen Brigham, who currently manages two clinics in Virginia. Records show that his license has been suspended, revoked, or allowed to lapse multiple times in several states. In 1994, the New York Health Department disciplined Brigham for botching a late-term abortion. The woman, 26 weeks pregnant at the time, bled for 3 hours before she was finally taken to an emergency room. In 2010, New Jersey suspended Brigham's license after the State Board of Medical Examiners concluded his clinic provided grossly negligent care to 5 patients. And 3 years ago, Brigham faced multiple murder charges after Maryland authorities found dozens of late-term aborted fetuses inside a freezer at one of his facilities. Investigators later dropped those charges because they could not determine if the babies had been aborted in the state. Now, because of a loophole in state law, Brigham is doing business in Virginia at American Women's Services in Fairfax and Virginia Women's Wellness Center in Virginia Beach.
We are aware of some of the issues that he has had in other states.
Given the history, CBN News asked the Virginia Board of Health why Brigham can be in the abortion business here.
We have confirmed that he's not a licensed practitioner in Virginia. There's nothing in the regulations that dictates who can and cannot own a facility of any type. So that's where we are with that.
CBN News reached out to Brigham for an interview, but our calls were not returned. Behind me is one of two abortion facilities operated by Dr. Stephen Brigham. Pro-lifers say as someone without a medical license to practice in the state, the doors should be closed.
We know the track record of his license being suspended and revoked in almost every state he's ever practiced in. So then when inspections start coming up here in Virginia of his clinics here, we get very concerned.
A recent inspection of his Virginia Beach clinic found that in January alone, 18 out of 44 women visiting the center faced complications. Discrepancies included improper hygiene and unsanitary injection practices. We asked about plans to address the problems.
The way the regulations are written is that when we do an inspection and we find and identify certain problems, the facility, whether it's an abortion facility again or any other type of facility that we regulate, they're given an opportunity to fix those issues.
But some examples go beyond those types of issues, especially ones witnessed by medical professionals from Brigham's past. In an interview with The New Yorker, an ER doctor who saw patients from Brigham's Pennsylvania clinic said, "The types of complications that we saw coming from them were so much worse, major perforations to the uterine arteries, defects in the uterus that we couldn't repair. I had to do 3 or 4 hysterectomies. I was scared for the patients." Cobb says the battle is all about the safety of women, a debate that's heating up across the state. Last year, the Virginia Board of Health approved hospital-like rules for abortion clinics.
Virginia's governor recently ordered a review of new regulations for abortion clinics. Pro-lifers here in the Commonwealth say it's an issue that places women's health at risk.
Virginia Delegate Ben Klein has been fighting for better rules to make clinics safer. He also wants to see Brigham's doors closed.
Well, it's very frustrating that in spite of his horrible history, that this man is allowed to operate abortion clinics in Virginia. You would think that Virginia health officials would want to keep him out of the Commonwealth and keep him from operating these kinds of clinics around the Commonwealth.
Cobb says she'll keep sounding the alarm about the horrors of Dr. Stephen Brigham in the hopes that he and any others like him will be put out of business. Charlene Aaron, CBN News.